In this video, we're going to talk about reduce function. We'll come back to this example right here to actually apply it in a more meaningful way. But before we do that, let's start with some background to understand how it actually operates. So I'm going to go to this running total tab, and all I've got is some numbers here. Let's actually add some space on top of this. When you work with reduce function, you're going to have something that's called initial value. Let's just do that. And we'll just set it to something. So for right now, I'm going to do 0. So imagine if our initial value here is 0. And then I'm going to go to this next line. And for each row in this array, I'm going to do some sort of calculation. So for example, I could take the 0, the initial value, and add this number to it. So if I'd enter, well, 0 plus this number is going to be this number, right? If I drag this formula down, what's going to happen is that in my next line here, we're going to take this new number and we're going to add it to that previous number that we had calculated in our previous step. And then we end up with this next line, where again, we're going to take this number in this current line and we're going to add it to our previous line total. And we're going to keep doing this until we get here. So in reduce function, you're going to have a lambda function, which is going to have a variable called, usually people call this accumulator or something like that, but I'm just going to call it the x. So this is our x variable. So what we basically do here, we take our x variable and we set some initial value to it. So it could be 0, it could be any other number. So for example, I could set this to start with 15,000. Now this is my initial value. So what's going to happen now in our next line, we're going to take our first number in our array and add it to our initial value, which is that 15,000. Now, at this point, we got this 21,278, right? Now, our x, that initially is 15,000, which is our initial value, then in this line now becomes 21,278. And then we keep changing that x variable. So next time, in our next line, we now add this number to our previous value, and so on and so on and so on and so on until we get our final value here. So that's the idea of reduce. So basically you have some sort of initial value, and then in each line in your array, you do some sort of calculation. This in this case is just simple like adding together, but it could be any calculation. Usually you would use that value you get in each line, and based on that value, you would do some sort of calculation that would somehow change our initial value. And then we keep working on that value until we get to the end, get the total. Now let's try to build the same thing with reduce. So I'm going to do equals reduce. And I'll take that initial value, see it as 15,000. I could click on the cell, 15,000, or I can just type that 15,000 here, comma. Then we have the array. So the array is going to be this. So basically the values we need to loop through, comma, and then we have a lambda function. So in this lambda function, you're gonna have two variables. One of them is gonna be that initial value that's gonna keep changing. So basically this x, comma, and then we have a second value, which is gonna be basically each row in this array. So I'm just gonna call it r. And then finally, after this comma, once you have that changing variable x and you have each row value from here, you can do your calculation. So I'm going to do x plus r. Close parentheses again. So again, x would now refer, see in this example that we do, the first time it's initial value, the next time it's what happens to that initial value after the calculation. And our r is going to be the value of each line here. So at this point, if I hit enter, see, it's going to give me this final value. Essentially, instead of doing this whole thing, we just get one formula that does all of it. There it is. So the reason it's called reduce is basically you take a whole array of things and you output one single result. So now let's try to create some more useful case of this. So I'm gonna go to this reduce tab. And in this example, let's say we're trying to get rid of all of these special characters out of here. So commas, semicolons, colons. How could we possibly do that? So the thing that you are going to probably most commonly misunderstand here is that when you see this list, you usually think about this list as the list you're gonna use as an array, but that would be the wrong approach. So what you wanna do instead here, we wanna think about this one row here, this first value, as our initial value. So let's just do this on a side. So I'm just gonna copy that value, and I'm gonna go here, paste that. So this is our initial value. So the array itself currently doesn't exist. So I'm gonna create that. So the array for me is gonna be that list of characters. So for example, semicolon, period, comma, this. For now, I'm gonna start with these. So if you think about how you actually search and replace, usually what you would do, you would go here and use something like substitute function, and you would take your text, which is gonna be this initial value, and then you'll take whatever it is you're trying to find and replace. So in this case, I'm gonna try to find this character, this semicolon, comma, and I'm gonna replace it by nothing, so double quotes. If I close parentheses and hit enter, you'll see that this will replace that semicolon. So now I could take this formula and drag it down again and see in each line as we go to the next line. Now we're gonna take the previous value here and then we're gonna do another replacement of the next character. And then at some point we also, when we replace a character that doesn't exist, nothing happens, right? So we started here, after we do all of these different replacements with this substitute formula, we end up here as the last value. We can combine all of this in a single formula using reduce. So how would that work? So I'm gonna go here and do reduce. And if you remember, we're gonna have initial value, which would be this, comma. Then we have our array, and again, our array is gonna be this list of characters, comma again. And then we have our lambda function, which is gonna have our x value that keeps changing. Let's just call it changing value this time, comma. And we're gonna have each row from our array. So I'm gonna do r, comma. Now we need to do the calculation. So if you remember, our calculation was, let me just comment this. This was our calculation, this substitute function. I'm gonna copy that without equal sign. Go back here, let's get rid of this, and paste that formula right here. So this is that substitute formula. So in this particular formula, now we need to replace this references. So F1, that would be this value that keeps changing, that we wanna keep replacing over and over again. So we just use changing value as that value here. And the thing we're trying to search, find, and replace, which is this C2, and if I just scroll left, see C2 would be one of these characters, it's gonna be the value in each row of our array. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna just do R, just like that. We're gonna close parentheses one more time, to close our lambda function, and another time to close our reduce function. And if I hit enter, see, we're able to get there with a single formula. So now I probably don't want to have all of this stuff here. Right now, from all of these, the only thing that I did use is this F1, which is initial value. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna remove that F1 out of here, and I'm gonna point to this A2 cell, which is the same value here in our data. And this way, I'm gonna hit enter, and it's gonna be the same thing. Now we can delete some of these from here. This is our formula now. So I could keep this array as is and just make it absolute reference. If I want a list like this, I could do that. Another option is to just hard code that array in a formula if you don't want to list them in your spreadsheet. I could do curly brackets array like this, and then I can do comma separated list in quotes. So I'll do the semicolon, comma, then I'll do my period, and then we'll do the next one, comma, and then the next one would be this. With comma, it gets a little tricky, but you have to be careful. So this is our first character. This is the second character. This is the third character, which is that comma. And this is our fourth character. So if I hit enter, I'm going to get the same results. Now I should be able to delete all of this and just have one formula that does all of these replacements for me. So now I should be able to reuse this on all of these lines. So I can take this and drag it down and see we basically go through each one of those and replace all of those characters. Now, as you can see, I did not replace this colon and this dash. So now it's going to be easy. All I have to do is just add to this list, comma. I'm going to go ahead and add that dash and then another comma, add that colon. And with this, if I drag this down, we have our replacements. So finally, if you wanted to have just an array formula here so that it basically just fills all the way down without having to drag the formula, then I could just take all of these, delete them, go back, and this reduce argument that I provide, A2, I can just point to this whole column like an array. And as you can see, that works just fine. Now, it might be a good idea to also add a trim function to remove those extra spaces. So what we would do after we do this whole reduce, we'll just add trim around this. And that should also remove our extra spaces. So there you have it. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.